The CES program teaches students both the hardware and software components. What we are strong at is what's called embedded systems, where you use microprocessors to control other devices. We here have a capstone design course that lasts the entire senior year. The goal of capstone design is to bring together everything that you have learned and actually design and build something that's useful to society.
We're working with another UW professor, Dr. James Gowell, to build an autonomous sensor array for a remote lake in Mount St. Helens. It's only accessible in the summer, and so he has to hike out there like once a month with like a lot of equipment.
This is the sensor that was provided to us.
It is connected to our microcontroller here, which we're using for prototyping. And the SD card is going to both have the measurements, and it's also going to have the times that we want the sensor to take the readings. So the clock that we have, the external clock, is going to trigger an interrupt, and it's going to take a reading just at those times. And the rest of the times, it's going to be in a low-powered mode. A couple days after we graduate in mid-June, we're going to help him like build the platform for it, and we're going to take it up in different pieces and then test it out for a few days. And hopefully this project will continue with the seniors next year, so we can give them any advice about like how we think they can improve.
In the world, one of the main problems is heart disease. It affects almost every first world country. It is the number one reason you're going to die early in this world. We're thinking, what can we do? So we started looking at different ways you could take blood pressure that have been developed since, you know, the somograph that's been around forever. So we saw a thing called pulse transit time. Basically what it is you take your pulse at two different points in your body, and then through some physics you can find out your blood pressure. And then we decided, well, we could really make this compact into one single sensor that you could just slip over your finger and then touch your neck at the same time, and we could get your blood pressure, and not only at just a single point, but a continuous blood pressure, which would be really useful for things like the sit-stand test, where you sit down and then you stand up to see how your blood pressure changes. With this device, you simply just take your blood pressure every day, you do nothing else, you show up to your doctor, he already has it, and you have a warning signal through the entire time if your blood pressure is raising over the days. After graduation, we plan on continuing this project. We actually already started in an LLC, and we want to take this product as far as we can, all the way to market if possible.
So our project is the DSLR Remote. As you see here, we have the high-end DSLR camera. We're controlling the pan and tilt functionality, as well as the zoom and focus. We're doing that remotely. We intend on using an Android application connected to a Raspberry Pi remotely via Wi-Fi.
Our client is actually a house of worship installation. The purpose for this device was actually to have the lead pastor be able to record himself while on stage, and this device allows for that.
So we do plan on finalizing this project after graduation, putting it into an actual consumer product. I have spoke with some of the staff over at Oracle who are also very interested in utilizing this product once it's completed. I think we'll probably start with a Kickstarter after we have our full proof of concept ready to go.
I came to UW Tacoma because it was local, and I know they had the CES program here because I didn't want to just do software. And the program is very embedded systems focused, and that's basically what we're building, like an embedded system, like as software light as possible to like control the hardware.
Yeah.
We've had some classes that have been directly applicable to the type of communication the sensor uses. Learning how to use like the equipment through like all the projects that we've had to do has really helped us figure out how to like debug all our problems.
We get to do so many different things in the realm of computer science and computer engineering. For this project in particular, I'm working on digital signal processing, so actually taking the pulse and finding the time difference between the two pulses on the body. And in the CES program, we learn how to use microcontrollers, we learn networking skills, and we learn digital signal processing, and I'm using all these things in our project. So I can just see how everything I'm learning in the program is going to be useful going forward in my career and hopefully growing this company really big.
So the CES program here really provided the framework on how to learn with embedded systems and software programming that allowed us to take things that we hadn't worked with before and learn how to use them on the fly and then apply them to what we needed to do, which is a large part of what this course is all about and what this program is all about is not really to teach you how to do one specific thing, but to give you the tools to work in the computer engineering field and be effective.